Greetings from Maryland. I'm bringing NASA into your home today as I tell you some of the fascinating ways in which NASA satellites are able to measure various things about our environment, including how much precipitation is falling. My name is Dorian Janney, and I am the Education and Outreach Specialist for the Global Precipitation Measurement Mission. I also work with the GLOBE program, and I'm a GLOBE Master Trainer, and I'm also a campaign coordinator for the GLOBE Mission Mosquito. I wanted to bring NASA into your home today as I show you an easy online activity that you can do. But I wanted to start off by showing you how many of us in the GLOBE program, and also with a citizen science group called COCO-ROS, measure precipitation that's falling in our own front or backyards. So what I have here is a rain gauge. With my rain gauge, I check it once a day. Usually I check mine in the morning around 8:30 or 9 a.m. and I find out how much precipitation has fallen within the past 24 hours. I'm gonna need two hands for this. So I'm gonna take the top off, and here I have my tube that's inside, and basically this is just giving me a measurement of the height of how much precipitation fell in the last 24 hours. We've had a lot of rain. As a matter of fact, here I have over half an inch of precipitation. In this case, my gauge is measuring precipitation in inches. We also have them that measure precipitation in millimeters. So I actually have 0.55, a little over a half of an inch, and I can show you that when I pour this into the rain gauge, and if we were just measuring it from the height there, you would see that it is a little more than a half of an inch. But we use this inner tube as kind of a zoom lens to help us be able to see more accurately how much precipitation has fallen. All right, let's go inside now, out of the rain, and I'm going to show you how you can use your computer and online resources to find out how much the Global Precipitation Measurement Mission measured in your back or front yard anytime over the past two decades. Well, it was really nice to welcome you to my yard to get a chance to see my rain gauge and how I use my rain gauge to be able to measure precipitation from the ground. There are also GLOBE schools all over the world that are using the GLOBE precipitation protocols and a rain gauge to be able to measure how much precipitation is falling in their schoolyards or in their own yards. And as I mentioned, the COCO-ROS program is a group of citizen scientists in the United States and Canada who are also using rain gauges and reporting in on their data in order to give us a better understanding and also keep those of us who are interested in doing this aware of how much precipitation is falling in our yards. So we're going to be working with this activity called From Satellite to Your Backyard. And I'm going to show you how you can find this activity right there on that website, gpm.nasa.gov/education. This has all of the directions that you're going to need to be taking you through how you can generate this information and better understand how much precipitation is falling and has fallen anytime over the past 20 years, using both the data from the TRIM mission and the GPM mission. So I'm going to start by just showing you, here's a world map, and there's about where I am in Maryland. Now, to do this, to be able to access the data, you're going to want to go to the Giovanni website. This is a free website. It is a good idea if you're going to work with this data and you want to be able to download data to go ahead and log in and get a free account. Otherwise, you can continue, but you're going to have more limited access than you're going to have if you use an account that you have set up. So once you're in here, and again, don't worry about memorizing this. All of these directions are in that activity, and you've got even hyperlinks in that online activity to be able to follow. But basically what you're going to be doing is you're going to come over to time series, and we're going to look at seasonal. We can look at this data, like I say, for any time over the past two decades. So I have over here that I want the iMerge final in my keyword. I like to kind of put that in first because then that helps to limit some of these other things. I put in that I want from 2000 to 2019. We do have about a 2.5 month delay in this final data product, this level 3 iMerge product that I like to work with. So you won't be able to get the data until about 2.5 to 3 months after right now, because in order to put together those different satellite datas, make it a nice clean product and include some of those rain gauge data, it takes a little while to do that. So again, I picked the iMerge final. And then this is kind of the magic of this. I told you you're going to be able to see it in your backyard. Now there actually is a 10 kilometer swath that GPM is measuring. And you know, sometimes it can be raining in your backyard and then across the street, it's not raining or snowing. So, you know, this isn't going to be exact, but it is certainly going to characterize the general amount of precipitation that's falling. So over here, I put in my longitude and latitude. I don't know why it has to do it in that order, and I have that in the notes, but you're going to be finding your decimal longitude and latitude, and then you just stick it in there. You just stick it in one time, so I put in -77.196.3, and then I put a comma, and then I put in 39.2538. You don't have to be, you know, you don't have to go 10 digits, but I just, so that's what I put in there. And now that knows where to be looking for this data. And again, I decided that I wanted to have seasonal, and then I put, and then after I put this information in, I put plot data. Then, depending on how much data you want and how fast your bandwidth connection is, it is going to generate your data. So that we wouldn't have to wait, I went ahead and got my graph to show you. So at first, this is a crazy looking graph. I chose inches, and so that's what's being displayed over here from 1 to 8 inches. I selected inches because that's what my rain gauge is measuring in. And that way I also like to compare and contrast it to my local airport, which is in inches where I live. But you can set it to inches or to millimeters. Just be sure for making these graphs that you set it to either millimeters per month or inches per month. So here I'm looking for my location at inches per month. And I chose from looking at this for just about the past 20 years, from 2000 to 2000, and I guess I go to 18 here. Now, this looks kind of crazy. Here's what we're seeing. This blue line here is showing us pretty much the winter, December, January, and February. Where I live, some of that is falling as snow. Some of it is, of course, falling as rain. What we're looking at, though, is liquid equivalence. So if it is snow, I let it melt in my rain gauge, and then I measure how much the liquid was. And so we can see here, as we're looking at this over the years, that where I live in Maryland, we have a very variable amount of precipitation that falls really throughout the seasons. And that's going to be important when I compare and contrast this to some other locations. So my black line, that's showing me the spring, March, April, and May. And so you can see, you know, often we have more precipitation, and generally where I live, that is in the form of being a liquid. So then our summer, that's always liquid where I live, maybe some hail sometimes, but you can see that, you know, there's some years where we get a lot of precipitation in the summer. So where this dot is here, this is showing me that in 2006, we got about 5.5 inches in that 3 month period. Usually where I live, we have gotten about 43 inches of precipitation per year. We are starting to see that that amount is changing, which is a very interesting and another reason why I like to keep track of that. And then of course, this is showing us the fall, the fall for the hemisphere that I live in, September, October, and November. And look at the variability there. Pretty interesting to see that, let's say over here in 2007, less than 3 inches of precipitation fell throughout the fall, that 3 month period. But over here in 2011, we had over 6 inches of precipitation that fell. And you can see over here a large amount of precipitation, and that's in the summer. We did experience a lot of flooding during that time, which is another thing that I just find really interesting about being able to look at this data from a seasonal perspective. So I wanted to show you some of this data from some other locations. Here, we're looking at a location in the South Sudan. And some of you may know, if you've learned about South Sudan, that they have suffered from a lot of problems with famine. And a lot of that is because they've had a lot of drought. So of course, with drought, we're talking about not enough precipitation. Now, if you look over here, again, this is in inches. My other graph for Maryland was going up to 6, 7, 8 inches falling in that 3 month period. Now here with this graph, we're going from 0 to 1.2 inches falling in those 3 month periods. Now, if you take a look here, when do you notice that in this area of the South Sudan, which season do they appear to get most of their precipitation, or more than they usually do? And so you might note that it is in their winter time. So January and February, and again, that's pretty variable. But let's see over here in 2006, they got almost an inch, but again, that's in a 3 month period. Over here in 2008, they got about an inch, but look, there was from about 2010 through 2016 when they did not get very much rain at all. And that is what was primarily responsible for the drought, which of course makes sense. A drought is talking about a situation in which you do not have much precipitation. And here we certainly can see that. I wanted to show you some other examples. So here is a location in India. And this is over here in Southeast Asia, they experience something called monsoons. Now, monsoons are where you have a lot of precipitation during certain months of the year and not very much precipitation during other months. And we certainly see that to be true. Look at the summer months there. And now look at the scale. Here we're going from 0 to 50 inches falling in that 3 month period. How amazing is that compared and contrasted to what we were seeing in the South Sudan? So you notice here that, some years, of course, there's a lot more precipitation than others, but we see there's clearly a dry season during December, January, and February, where that blue line is, and clearly a very wet season during their monsoon season in the summer. I wanted to give you an example of some of the GPM measurement data. So here we see in 2017, from July through September, there were extremely heavy monsoon rains. Unfortunately, it resulted in the deaths of many, many people and destroyed lots and lots of homes. What this stresses to us is how important it is to know how much precipitation is falling so that the government officials and the public health officials can be prepared for these extreme events. All right, so if you'd like to do this activity and you are with a Globe School, I have set up an activity where you're able to go in here and compare and contrast how much precipitation you found, or you can go on and do this using any data. You don't even have to be a Globe School that is within the Globe program by using the data visualization tool. Go in there and compare and contrast how much precipitation the rain gauges found to how much precipitation the satellite found. You also can go to our precipitation education website and find all kinds of activities. There's an activity called Precipitation Towers, which takes some of that information I was showing you for different locations around the world and shows you how you can just use blocks or Legos to make a three-dimensional bar graph of how much precipitation is falling. You could make those for your own location. We'd love to see them. Also, be sure to take a look at the GPM website. get a feel for the precipitation measurement missions. Now it's the GPM website. And you can see the TRIM mission I was telling you about, Tropical Rainfall Measurement Mission, and the GPM mission, and learn all kinds of really interesting things about how and why we measure precipitation from space. Well, I hope you enjoyed this presentation, and I hope that you'll enjoy doing some NASA at home. Have a wonderful rest of your day.